Hey YouTubers, welcome back to part two of my motherboard and hardware upgrade video. Part one, we did the motherboard installation. And part two, what we're gonna do right now is the hardware installation. We're gonna be upgrading the SATA drive with an SSD drive. And I'm gonna be taking out the optical drive and putting in a secondary hard drive in its place. So let's begin. I'm also going to time how long it takes to actually start up my computer before I actually change that, and then I'll time it after my upgrades have been applied. I'm gonna hit them both at the same time. Let's begin. Okay, I'm gonna call that about a minute, and I'm gonna take 3 seconds off because I delayed on hitting that enter button. So I'm gonna say that's about a minute and 38 seconds. I'm gonna take 3 seconds off of that. So now I'm going to connect my hard drive caddy, this one here, with the new SATA drive that I'm going to install. So we're going to clone it. I have the app downloaded that I'm going to clone it with the Samsung app. So let's begin. And before we begin, let's time how long it takes to shut it down. And by shutting it down, I mean I need to have both of my white lights off here, and the light on the top is on. So let's shut it down. have my white lights on here, so it's still working. They went off. That took about a minute, 28 seconds. Doesn't have to be tight with the screws. They just want to be snug. Okay, let's open the app. Accept the terms. Click install to begin the installation. So while that is installing, okay, I'm back. Took about 2 hours to clone my drive, but it did finish and it completely copied my original hard drive. See, I have 298 gigs on my original hard drive, and then the clone copied 298 gigabytes on my backup, on my my new SSD drive. So what I'm going to do now is swap out the hard drive and switch out the optical drive. pretty secure. Got a little space right here, so I'm gonna cut a piece of this foam and stick it right up in there. Now, in order to secure it, I'm gonna have to take off this little piece right here. That's where this screw goes in to secure it. I'll put that piece right there on the new caddy right here. screw. Screw hole will go right there. It comes with four screws to secure the bottom of the SATA drive. So that's what I'll be putting in right now. Pretty secure. Let's reconnect the battery. Replace our back cover. It's all on there. And as you can see, my drive is just as flush as it was before. unit are complete. Okay, now our timer, before we did the hardware upgrade, was 1 minute 38 seconds. Let's see what we have with the hardware upgrade, and I'm gonna start it now. That's good. We did it in 31 seconds. That's a whole minute earlier than what it was doing before. So that's really good. So our hardware upgrades did exactly what it was supposed to do and what I was looking for. A faster boot. Let's see, it opens up my applications faster than what it did before. Yeah, it's running a little, it's running a lot faster than what it did before. So touch response is good as normal. Okay, I don't have that installed. Let's see. Yeah, compared to what it was before I did the hardware upgrade and the motherboard, it's moving faster than what it was. It's quieter because it doesn't have the mechanical drive noise, so it's very quiet. Open up my web browser. Everything loads up pretty good and pretty fast. I'm very happy with it. I'm very pleased with the result. Yeah, I'm very pleased with it. Files that I cloned, everything is there. My music is there, my photos are there. And it shows 500. Well, 464 gigabytes. And 167 gigabytes free. Okay, now we gotta find our 2 terabyte secondary hard drive. because right now it doesn't show up in my file explorer. As you can see, I only have the one SSD drive that's viewed. So we have to get our 2 terabyte drive started. So I'm gonna tap in the search. I'm gonna go to view my RAM. I'll come down to my storage. Shows my C drive, so I'm gonna go to disk management. And we're gonna go right here to initialize a new drive. And it tells you right here how to do that. Type in disk management. Must initialize disk before Logical Disk Manager can access it. And here is our unallocated disk right here. So disk one is our secondary drive right there. And I'm not gonna use it as a master boot. So, okay, we're gonna right click the unallocated space. Welcome to the new simple volume wizard. Assign a drive letter, and I'm going to use I'll stick with letter D. Format the partition. now we're formatting the drive so that we'll be able to use it. Drive is formatted and it took us directly to the D drive. Now let's see if it shows up in our file folder list. It does. Show us right there. We've got a total of 1.81 terabytes free on our secondary hard drive. So our secondary hard drive is up and running. So that pretty much concludes part two video. We made some pretty good changes. The computer's operating faster than it was before. I'm gonna close all my windows. And it didn't take that long to actually get everything together. I would say without me recording the video and everything, it would have probably taken me only maybe 20 minutes, 20-25 minutes at the most. And that is involving replacing the motherboard and replacing the hard drive and caddy and everything. Making the video, it probably took longer because I had to pause, stop, and comment on everything. So all in all, I think it was well worth it. So thank you for joining. See you next time. Bye-bye.